Grade 5 Math, Number 1, Place Value and Patterns. Remember from 3rd and 4th grade, we did place values. And if you remember, there's the ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, etc. And as we move to the next place value, we're multiplying by 10. If we have 4 in the ones place and we multiply it by 10, it gives us 40. See? We multiplied by 10 to get the 40. If we have a number here and we want to go back, we're dividing to go back smaller. If you have 500 and you multiplied it by 10 and got 5,000, you could divide it by 10 and get back to the 500. See? 500 is 1/10 of the 5,000 because it takes 10 of them to get the 5,000. All right? It takes 10 fours to get to be the 40, so 4 is 1/10 of 40. See? Our number system is base 10. As we move towards the left, the values increase by multiplying by 10. As we move to the right, the values decrease to 1/10 of the previous place value. So if we had 100 and we moved over and had a 10, one of the 10s would be 1/10 of that 100 because it takes 10 of them to make the 100. 20 is 10 times as much as a 2 because 20 divided by 2 equals 10. See? 10 times 2 is 20. And 20 is 1/10 of 200 because 20 times 10 is 200. We're pretty much just multiplying the number by the denominator, see? Do you remember our fractions? 2 is 1/3 of 6. We multiply the 2 times the denominator. 2 times 3 is 6. Here's 6 squares. 2 of them would be 1/3 of the 6, see? So, in order to do these, we would divide. 200 divided by 20, and that would tell us the answer. How many times can 20 fit into 200? We can do it this way. How many 20s fit into that 20? Because it can't fit into the 2. How many 20s fit into the 20? One of them. We do the multiplication, 20 times that 1. We do our subtraction. We drop the 0 down. We get 0, and we put a 0 up here. So 200 is 10 times as much as 20. We also could have said 20 times what is 200? Because multiplication and division are the inverse opposite of each other, right? So 20 times something is equal to 200. How about this? 50 is blank times as much as 5. 5 times what is 50? Well, if we did it the opposite way by multiplying instead of dividing, 5 times 10 is 50, right? How about here? 4,000 is blank times as much as 40. We can do 4,000 divided by 40, or we can say how 40 times what is equal to 4,000. What would we need to multiply the 40 by to get to 4,000? See? If we had 4,000 and we divided it by 40, this 40 goes into this 40 one time. We do our subtraction and get 0, and then above these zeros we put zeros, so we can see it's 100 times. And to check it, 40 times 100 is 4,000, see? 80,000 is blank times as much as 8,000. Well, actually, if you took those three zeros off and had an 8, and took those three zeros off and had an 80, 8 is how many times more than 80? What do you need to multiply 8 by to get 80? 10. You have 8 1,000s or 80 1,000s, see? So that would be 10. And you could do the division if you want to check it, or the multiplication. All right, so to find a 1/10 of a number, we're going to divide, we're going to multiply by the denominator. So 50 times 10... 50 times 10 Do you know how the trick to do this really quick? You do 1 times 5 is 5 and you add the two zeros. We could do it the long way. 0 times 0 is 0, 0 times 0 is 0, 1 times 0 is 0, 1 times 5 is 5, and get 500. But 50 is 1/10 of 500, because 50 times 10 is 500. 500 divided by 50 is 10, see? I know this sounds really confusing, so just stay with me. 300 is 1/10 of what number? Just like we did, the 2 is 1/3 of 6 down here. We're going to multiply the 300 times the 10. 300 times 10 is a 3 with 3 zeros. See, 1, 2, 3. A 3 with 3 zeros. So it's 3,000. Okay? 400 times 10 is going to be a 1 times 4 with 3 zeros. 1, 2, 3. 7,000 is 1/10 of what number? We're going to multiply the 7,000 times 10. We're going to do 1 times 7, which is 7, and we're going to add the 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. And it's going to give us 70,000. And you could do it the old way if you want. You know, you could do it this way. But whenever you're multiplying by tens or hundreds, you can just count the zeros and put the zeros on. All right? So basically, all they're saying is, because it takes 10 of these 300s to get 3,000, one of the 300s is a 1/10 of it, okay? Because it takes 10 2s to make a 20, this 1 2 is 1/10 of that 20, see? If we had 10 2s, ten times two is 20, so all of these together equal 20, and then if we only had one of them, this one, it would be 1/10 of these circles, see? It would be one of the 10, it would be 1/10, so two would be 1/10, see? And then just remember, when you have to find how many times a number is, you can just divide that small number into the bigger number, and that'll tell you how many times, all right? There's a reason we're doing this. We're going to start getting into exponents soon, and you need to understand how a number can be 100 or 10 or 1,000 times another number, because we're going to be getting into exponents and stuff, and we want you to understand this, okay? I hope this helped. See you next video. Bye.